The troopers you see before you today are all active duty soldiers currently assigned to commanding generals and other color guards that belong to the division headquarters and the headquarters battalion of the 1st Infantry Division, the Big Red One. Cavalry troopers would fine-tune their riding skills by practicing mounted drill and ceremony. Our riders will now conduct a saber melee, as the cavalry would have with their sabers drawn in what is known as Pierce Point. This position is with the keen edge of the saber cut and respectfully the tip of the saber pointed at the ground. Soldiers frequently perform this exercise to ensure their mount will remain calm, collected, and brave in battle. The ring stand is the primary tool utilized to develop a soldier's hand-eye coordination. It is important that all soldiers master this technique prior to their participation in other saber-related activities. This drill takes extreme precision, aim, and skill. Watch as our troopers make their best effort to master the ring stand.
She got it.
Over here we have Trooper Martin on the newest course, Scout.
Here comes another one. Got it. See the ring? You got it. Another ring. There we go. Another one. You got it. And he throws it up.
Over here is Sergeant Stalker on Lexington. And you have Corporal Felix over there riding the saber.
So they run the sword through it and they fling it up into the air. And I guess they're calling them sword sabers. They're a little bit different. One of these horses is named Fox.
From the days of the American Revolution until 1931, the mounted cavalrymen were armed with a saber. The saber has a single edge and a curved blade. Its primary purpose was for the close quarters combat with the enemy. And to perfect its use, a saber assault course was developed. The course was designed to hone the soldier's ability to negotiate obstacles and engage targets simultaneously. Our soldiers are now demonstrating a scaled-down version of the saber assault course. Here you have Sergeant Mortimer riding the Lookout. Lookout is actually one of the five Mustangs we have on the team. Good job, Sergeant Mortimer.
I actually enjoy this song.
Here you have Sergeant Stalker on Lexington.
So his horse is named Lexington. Like Lexington to Kentucky.
See him come around them. Start to see if you can get one there. One. To the town of Albuquerque, rode a strange. Good job, Sergeant Stalker.
The weapon you see actually shooting
is now 1873 Colt single action. The strange originally used the 36 caliber revolver. Until 1847, when the 44 caliber revolver was fielded to the cavalry. It was used extensively in the Civil War by both armies. As you all see, the ability to engage your targets while riding a horse takes extreme precision and countless hours of practice. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Good shot, Corporal Seaman. In this town, there's two in one shot there. By the name of Texas. Men had tried to take him, and men were dead. He was. Troopers are now paired up as a team.
So the teams could work closely together to defeat the enemy. Precision on horseback is not just limited to the accuracy with a saber. A rider and his mount were trained together to be a saber.
Very nice. Here goes again.
Fox and
Lookout.
For a second there, I didn't think about letting Sergeant Mortimer get a target on the Serpentines. Here comes Sergeant Stocker and Trooper Seaman.
WMIA and US flag.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Commanding General's Mounted Color Guard, we sincerely hope you enjoyed today's performance. We would like to thank the deployed, brave, and responsible on-point soldiers, past, present, and future, for all the freedoms that we enjoyed today. And to all our fallen soldiers, we will never forget, no mission too difficult, no sacrifice too great, duty first.
I see him every day.
How long have you been riding?
A year.
That's Lookout?
Yep.
How long do you practice every day?
This horse is Lookout.
Whenever we can.
A lot of the time.
We want to play.
Yeah.
Volunteer and go out for a 60-day tryout period.
So before you did this, have you ever ridden horses?
No.
Oh, really?
Good for you.
Oh, my goodness.
Before you came in, 88 Mike.
Yeah.
So.
So now you do you have to take care of him and everything, or does somebody else do that?
I'm the stable master, so all of the horses are my responsibility. So medical and everything,
really?
We're gonna take care of them.
Went from an iron horse to a flesh and blood, huh?
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
To a real one.
I think so too. Has he ever bit you?
Him, no.
Do horses bite you, don't they?
Yeah. He steps on me, but.
How old is he, you know?
He's 10. He's a Mustang, and he was caught in Nevada when he was 3.
Cool.
It was wild?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay, cowboy.
So this is the Mustang brand. All wild horses are branded with them. So a code for the location of where they're from.
Oh, you're good. Yeah, you're good.
And then he was broke in Hutchinson, Kansas, at the prison.
Oh, yay.
Wow.
Breaking.
Oh, wow.
Just put his saddle on and direct rein, and that's it.
Do you do all of them direct range?
No, we can't.
You can't?
No. We either use a saber and a pistol and carrying flags or ceremonies where we just got to stand still.
You have to do that. What do they call it, right?
Indirect range.
Indirect.
I hear you sing twice because I love it.
And you are a staff sergeant?
Sergeant.
Sergeant.
Yep.
What's your
Mortimer.
Sergeant Mortimer,
yep.
And this is Lookout.
This is Lookout.
Sergeant Mortimer and Lookout.
You're welcome. Yeah.
That lady that was riding, what's her horse's name?
That's Saber. That's Old Man Saber. Yeah, in 2 years he'll be retired. And somebody can adopt him. Anybody can adopt them when they're up for retirement.
Dad, what is that hot on his?
That's his breast collar. So that would mean a horse went to war?
Wow.
He didn't.
Oh, okay.
But
for demonstration.
Yep, back then that's what it would mean.
I guess you have to beat him.
What's that? Beat him? Go ahead. See if he'll, you can see if he'll eat it.
I want to get up the
chew. Do you want to try feeding him?
Well, yeah, you touch Bella. I don't touch different
horses. That's close
enough.
You
don't touch different horses?
Yeah.
No?
I only touch other horses that I know like better.
Oh, yeah?
Those are my
horses. Your horse, huh? So he thinks the rope is cool.
I love the rope.
Yeah. Yeah, he probably doesn't, huh?
There he is.
Yes, they will. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, that hurts.
Okay, Corbel, come back out of there.
Yeah.
Come back out of there.
Nice.
Come on,
baby.
Good job. Let's go to this one.
This does? Yeah. Do you like the jump?
Oh, this is Lookout. Maybe he's hungry.
Guns? You're taking the swords like that? Yeah. He's a gentle. He's very gentle. Yeah. he's tired too. He's taking a nap. Maybe he does need to eat, I know.
I think he eats it. I think he eats enough.
He's our biggest horse.
He's 1,490 pounds.
No, he's got the U.S. on there.
The U.S.
Say pounds?
United States. So he's a real army horse. So he works for his grass from the army.
Daddy should play some
back. Oh, yeah.
How many hams is he?
Almost 16.
I thought he's so big.
Yeah.
Do you want to go look at some of the others?
He's beautiful.
He is. He's almost the biggest, but.
Is he the Mustang?
Yeah, he's the Mustang.
Yeah, Lookout, right?
Yeah, yep. we have five of them.
Okay. Yeah.
Lookout, Duke, Apache, Chief, and Bass. Or Mustang.
He's the only Lookout. One here tonight.
What's the last one?
Okay.
Vast, like long distance,
yep.
Or far away.
Yep, right. What's his chief? Lookout.
Is the tallest one?
What's the what?
Is that the tallest?
No, he's the tallest and he's the heaviest.
Is chief the youngest?
Chief is 10. Vast is the youngest. He's only 6.
Yeah, we can. Okay, but wait a minute. You guys, let's see. Katie, do you want to go look at the next one?
That one's tall to me.
You want to go look at the next one, Katie?
That one is Fox down there. He's got a nice white blaze on his face.
That one's Fox.
They thought it fit him. Yeah. I know, right? It happens. I know. His little star? Yeah. And he has two white socks.
I think you should name him Zach.
Socks?
Yeah.
That wouldn't be that bad, huh?
Kind of gonna find you some
in your ass. Yeah, I mean it'd be a lot easier if we shaved it.
Oh, well.
So what they do is it's white because we freeze brand them.
Uh-huh.
So it's a brass brand and you stick it in liquid nitrogen.
Liquid nitrogen.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah, it doesn't. There's not as much pain as
right. Hot
brand.
Good.
Yep.
Good.
Most of them will just sit there and take it and not even move.
Really? Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good.
Some of them, they don't have
it.
Yeah, one of them here is his name's Scout. That's the
name. He's a little scared.
Yeah. You can see he's got one little messed up letter.
Oh yeah.
Can you call that ice branding?
Freeze brand.
Freeze branding.
Yep, freeze brand. They do have sharp teeth, yeah.
It's kind of odd how they have teeth. I know. And he needs to brush.
I can't read that brand. Where was he caught?
Nevada.
Is that what that says, Nevada?
Yep. It'll show a date and then... So the first part's the date and then Nevada.
You can barely tell it's Nevada.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think he
missed
his supper.
He always eats. He thinks he's starving.
But he's not.
Never. Yes, that's him.
Thanks for a good show, Sergeant.
Thank you,
thank you for your service.
No problem. You too.
Thank you.
Take it easy.
Thank you. You too.